A galvanic cell is constructed with Ag plus Ag means silver electrode, Fe plus 3 Fe plus 2 means redox electrode. Find the concentration of Ag plus at which EMF of the cell is zero and the concentration of Fe plus 3 Fe plus 2 are same. The standard potentials of electrodes are, so they are given potentials of electrodes, silver electrode as well as redox electrode potentials are given to us. So we need to find out the concentration of Ag plus at which the concentrations of Fe plus 2 Fe plus 3 are equal, and they have given us standard potentials of silver as well as redox electrode now. So here we need to apply Nernst equation for this. First of all, we should know which is electrode, means which is anode, which is cathode, because they are not given in the question. For this, what we have to see is whichever electrode is having higher SRP value, means higher standard reduction potential value, that is going to act as cathode. And whichever electrode has lesser reduction potential value, that is going to act as anode. Therefore, higher SRP value is for silver only. Hence, we can say that silver electrode, means silver electrode is going to act as cathode. Now, so silver is cathode. Okay. And then iron is coming out as anode now. So we have decided anode as well as cathode. So we can find out the E naught of cell. What is E naught of cell? E naught of cell means E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode. So we found out E naught of cell now. Then comes, you require cell reaction. To know the reactants and products, we should know cell reaction there now. After knowing the cell reaction, we can apply Nernst equation for that. Okay, so we should write cell reaction, then find out products and then reactants, and the value of N we should find out from cell reaction, and then we can apply Nernst equation for that. Let us see the steps first. So first one is, you are calculating E naught value of the cell now. So E naught value. E naught value of the cell is given as E naught of cathode minus E naught of anode you have, which is equal to cathode is what? Silver. What is the value given there? 0.8. Anode is 0.77. The value comes out to be 0.03. So we know the E naught of cell now. What is second step now? We are now writing the cell reaction there now. Cell reaction. While writing cell reaction, we follow a standard procedure. First, we are going to write down always anodic reaction first. So, I am writing anodic reaction. So, what is anode here? Anode, we know that it is a ion. Itself is anode for us now. So, oxidation. So, it is nothing but Fe plus 2. Undergoing oxidation, giving rise to Fe plus 3 plus electrons. Then coming towards cathode. Which is cathode here? Silver electrode we have. So therefore it is Ag plus plus electron giving rise to Ag we have now. So write the net reaction now. So here only you have one electron transfer, means in the reaction value of N is equal to 1. So what is the final reaction we have now? That is Fe plus 2 plus we have there Ag plus giving rise to Fe plus 3 plus Ag we have. This is the reaction we have. Now, let us write the Nernst equation, then apply the reaction which is known to us now. Let us write the Nernst equation. It says E is equal to E naught of cell minus 0.0591 by N into log of Q will come. So here, let us substitute the values. Now, he says that EMF of the cell is 0. So this 0 here is equal to E naught value of cell, just now we found out 0.03 we have, minus 0.0591. One is electron transfer here, log of products by reactants now. What are products there now? Products are Fe plus 3 you have, Fe plus 3 ions. We cannot write in the product silver because it's a metal. So you take always metal as unit concentration by reactants are what? Reactants are Fe plus 2. And then you have their silver ions there now. And in the question they are given is concentration of Fe plus 3 and Fe plus 2 are same. Therefore, we can cancel Fe plus 2 and Fe plus 3 concentrations now. So therefore, which is equal to means we can write 0.03 here. Of course, minus sign, we cancel signs on both sides, is equal to 0.0591 into, we can write it as log of 1 by Ag plus then now. So let us inverse log of Ag plus means here now. So we'll take like this. So 1 by log of Ag plus is equal to 1 by log of Ag plus is equal to 1 by, because we have log of Ag, so log of 1 by Ag plus is equal to, so 0.03 by 0.0591, which is equal to approximately the value comes out to be 0.5 then now. Approximately value is 0.5. Okay. Now it is log 1 by Ag plus 0.5 here. Let us take first of all log of Ag plus. So log Ag plus will be equal to minus 0.5 will come. Now we need to take antilog of negative value. You know that we need to add one and subtract one. So Ag plus is equal to, it will be antilog. Antilog of negative number, no? We need to add one and subtract one. So it becomes bar 1.5, which is equal to, we have to see the tables book for antilog of 0.5. So therefore, the answer will be 0.31 finally. This is the concentration of Ag plus we have. So, let us see the answer. So these are the options given to us. So answer must be option C then now. So C is the answer we have.